This is the darkest story I have ever heard. And in all my life, I have labored not to tell it.
It's a shame about Miss Troy.
Still hard to believe that somebody could do something like that.
Yeah, it is.
I should have never let her go into the woods by herself.
She wanted to. You had to let her.
Something was bothering her. I could tell she had something on her mind. I guess that's why I wanted to wait for her, but she said no. I asked her if she wanted me to come back for her a little later, but she said no to that too. That look on her face, Ben, when I found her, I mean, it was like the soul had been scooped right out of her. An awful thing for a teenage boy to see. I still can't imagine why. Can you, Ben?
Hey, Mr. Bailey mentioned something that only hate could do a thing like that.
Maybe. But you know, I've never quite believed that explanation.
Why not?
Because there wasn't all that much to hate, even here, even then.
Nifty. Gotta go. Y'all behave yourselves now. much of a speaker, but I just wanted to give a special welcome to the new freshman class at Choctaw High this year. I'm sure you'll be a little lost at first, but it doesn't take long to get the hang of it. And I'm sure you'll be right at home before long. Woo!
Wade, Benway, just the guy I wanted to see. You want to edit the Wildcat?
Not particularly.
Great! You can start tomorrow. Go see Miss Carver. She's full of ideas.
Good morning, class. My name is Mrs. Carver, and I'd like to welcome you to your literature class. First off, we're going to start reading a book called Wuthering Heights. I think you guys will really enjoy it. I'm just going to pass it out.
Get started. Do you know it? Hey, Ida. Do you know who that girl is over there?
Well, that's Kelly Troy. I heard she's from Baltimore.
Where did you see the defendant, Miss Sparks?
Coming out of the woods.
Whereabouts?
At the top of Breakheart Hill.
What was he doing?
Wiping off his hands.
With what?
A handkerchief.
What color the handkerchief was?
It was white.
What was on the handkerchief?
It was blood.
Oh, that's cool.
Who are we?
Wildcats!
Who are we?
Wildcats!
Wildcats!
Get your head in the game!
But I'm doing really well right now.
How's practice?
Just fine. Except for Todd and his personal butt lick over there. You know, I'm kind of hungry. Let's go to Coffee's for something cold.
Right.
So where do you think it all started then?
What started?
The thing that Dunn did Kelly in.
I guess everything has a beginning, even something like that.
Maybe. Especially something like that. Specific cause.
Maybe it began with something innocent.
Like what?
Like a poem.
Oh, hey.
Hi.
Are you looking for somebody?
You.
Me?
Miss Carver sent me down here. Which is why I brought you this! It's a poem. Do you publish poems in the Wildcat?
I publish just about anything.
You mean whether it's any good or not?
Well, I don't have a lot to choose from. You know, Choctaw High. Rah, rah, rah.
It's just a few lines. If you don't like it, you can tell me.
No matter what, it's probably better than most of the stuff I get in here. Do you want me to read it now?
No. Later.
Okay.
Well, I have to get to the bus. I guess you'll let me know.
Tomorrow. I'll read it tonight and talk to you tomorrow.
Okay. I seriously been
Kelly, can I talk to you for a minute?
See you, Kelly.
See ya. I read your poem. I liked it a lot.
Well, I wrote a few things in my own school.
Well, if you have anything else written, I'd love to see it.
Okay.
I'm so ready for
this. Thanks, Ben.
So I heard you and Kelly Troy were having a little heart-to-heart there in the hallway.
Sheila Cameron has a big mouth.
What did you even talk about?
It's just something she wrote for the Wildcat.
Oh, sure. Look, I told Betty Ann I'd meet her, so see you later.
Yeah.
Wade. Ben Wade. Right?
Yeah.
I never forget a name. So, you and Luke Duchamp were at Coffee's a few weeks back, right? Getting any?
Don't worry. Someday you'll get married and you'll get way more than you wanted to. Wearing it out.
I don't think I could ever get enough.
Oh, old man Avery's probably gonna be looking down your precinct thinking, oh, there's Lyle Gates. I wonder what that troublemaker's up to.
It's better than him thinking you're a hobnogger.
Well, seems like nothing much has changed around old Choctaw High.
Well, we got a new girl from up north.
Up north, you say?
Up north, that's right. She is good looking.
Well, you know I went to a Yankee.
You do this one. Woo-wee! She is fine.
Gotta go.
I didn't know you hung out with Lyle.
I don't hang out with him. We just shoot a game down at the pool hall once in a while.
What's he doing here anyway?
Just checking things out, I guess. You seen Todd?
No.
I hope he doesn't leave without me.
I read Kelly's issue in the Wildcat. The rest of the issue
doesn't live up to it. I know.
But maybe it could. I've talked to Kelly and she's willing to work with you on it. I think you two might make a good team. As co-editors, I mean.
Well, just tell her to come down here as soon as she gets the chance.
Hi.
Miss Carver said you wanted to work with me on the Wildcat. I think that's great. You could definitely add something to it. Something new, like a perspective. Of Choctaw, I mean. A different point of view. Northern.
Do you have a car? Because I need a ride after school.
Just an old Chevy, but it runs okay.
Mother, this is Wade, Ben Wade.
Wade Luther Wade's son?
Yes, ma'am.
You were just a little boy when I saw you last. You were about 6 years old. Do you remember going into Wade, Mr. Wade's store? Well, tell your father I say hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, thanks again for the lift.
I'll see you tomorrow.
We're gonna make the Wildcat a really good paper, Kelly. The two of us, together.
I think so too.
Hey Kelly, what do you think of this? It's a gossip piece that Allison would have put in. June Compton gave it to me this morning.
Trouble in Paradise. Be on the lookout for a breakup.
Who is it about?
Just some Turtle Grove couple. That's all June knows about. The people up there.
Hi, Ben. Hey, Kelly. Y'all working on the Wildcat?
Yeah.
Well, I was just wondering if June Compton gave you something to put in it.
Yeah, she did.
Well, do you think I could have it back? It's kind of personal, and I don't want it in the Wildcat.
Well, I'd like to give it to you, Mary, but I should probably read it first, because that's what good editors do.
I wish you wouldn't, Ben. It's personal, you know?
I know, Mary, but as the editor of the paper, I should probably...
Here you go, Mary. June gave it to us this morning. We haven't even had a chance to read it yet.
Oh, goody! So glad you gave this back. You know, June Compton is a busybody. It's really not bad, you know. It's just, I don't want anyone to know. Well, bye.
That breakup stuff must have been about her and Todd. They must be having trouble.
You should have given it to her right away.
What do you mean?
You made her beg, Ben. Why? Why did you make her beg?
You're right. I should have just given her back the paper.
It must be nice, though.
Nice? What must be nice?
To love someone like that? Like Mary loves Todd? To feel desperate about losing someone?
Have you ever felt that way about somebody?
No. But I hope to someday. Would you have run it?
Run what?
The note June gave you. Would you have run it in the Wildcat?
I don't know. I might have run it. But if I did, I would feel bad later. That's the worst. Disappointing people you admire. Even yourself. Don't you think?
No. The worst thing is for someone you love to disappoint you.
But I'm glad we gave Mary your note back.
Me too. You this, Kelly, but what are your plans to do after high school?
I don't have any plans.
I mean, like, what college are you going to?
I don't know that either. Do you think everybody has to go to college?
It seems like the next step.
In what? The next step in life, you mean?
I guess you could call it that. I don't really know any other step.
Lots of people just get jobs and get married. They have children and settle into.
But not you. You wouldn't settle for a life like that.
Why not?
Because you wouldn't be happy with it. You're so different. I mean, you're smart and everything. You should go to college.
Well, if I can get the money.
Can your mother afford to send you? Is there anyone else who would help you?
There's no one else.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
I don't have a father, Ben. Just leave it at that.
Sure. Okay.
Well, good night, then.
You must have a thing for Kelly Troy.
Bull crap.
You talk about her all the time. It's always, Kelly and I did this, or Kelly and I did that. And you're always working with her in that little basement office or yours or driving around or something.
We have to work on the Wildcat after school. The buses are gone by that time, so I have to drive her home.
Have to? Like it's your job? You should ask her out, Ben. That's what guys do when they like girls. They show their affection. Go to movies. You know, things like that. Why not? She's not gonna be the new girl forever. Eventually, someone will have asked her out, and by then, you'll have lost your chance. I don't get it. If you like her, just ask her out. It's simple.
There's no point in asking Kelly out because she lives in Choctaw now, and she likes it here. I'm not going to come back after college, and so there's no point in getting involved with her, you know, like that.
So you're just going to delay your whole life until you leave Choctaw? You're just going to stay neutral for the next year and a half?
I'll be busy. It's not that easy getting into medical school.
You know what your trouble is, Ben? You need to have everything in a certain order. Well then, maybe I'll ask her out. Do you think she might go?
I thought you were going to study with Betty Ann.
Betty Ann's nice, but I'd like to get to know somebody different, like a girl from up north.
Well then ask her then.
You're afraid of her, aren't you?
Afraid? Why would I be afraid?
We're always afraid of the girl we're in love with, Ben.
Mighty fine day out here, isn't it, Lucas?
Yeah, could be nicer. I mean,
you know, you've always been negative. You and your mother both.
What do you know about my mother?
You know, I know a lot about your mother.
Oh yeah, like what?
We've been friends for years.
My mother's dead.
And my mother's dead too.
Why didn't Kelly call you that day, Ben?
Call me what day?
When she needed a ride after Breakheart Hill. You were always giving her a ride, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
So why didn't she call you that day? I've never been able to figure that out.
Maybe she did call me, Luke.
You mean you weren't home that afternoon?
No, I was not.
Well, where were you?
I guess you can say I was running some errands.
Why?
I was just driving around. Maybe I had lots of things on my mind. I do that often.
What things?
I don't know, the play, schoolwork. I don't know. I just don't know.
Did you know why she was going up there that day?
No, I didn't.
She was upset about something, but she didn't tell me what it was. Why would she have wanted to go up there in the first place?
Really, I do not know. Maybe she wanted to rehearse some lines for the play. Maybe she just wanted to relax.
Just needed to think. That's all she said.
Well, maybe that's why.
What could have been so important for her to think about that afternoon?
I don't know. Maybe she was rehearsing her lines for the play.
If that were why, she would have had a copy of the play with her. Sheriff Stone had another idea. He thought that she planned to meet somebody up there.
Why would he think that?
Because she hadn't made any arrangements for anybody to pick her up. That always bothered Sheriff Stone. He'd always asked if she mentioned something about my coming back, and I told him that I had offered, but she said not to.
I'm gonna flip shit.
And you know what Sheriff Stone said? He said, there's something wrong with all of this. Why would Kelly not have wanted me to come back with her, Ben?
Maybe she intended on walking back.
I don't think so. Cranberry, it was 2 miles back to Choctaw. She wouldn't walk that, would she?
Probably not. Not the Kelly I knew. You know, maybe she was going down to that store. Not Charlie's County Market. Grierson's. Grierson's.
What about
maybe
it?
She was going to call someone and ask for a ride.
To pick her up, you mean?
Yeah, exactly.
No way, Ben. It was a Sunday. That store was closed.
Good point. How do you know?
Because that's where he was. That's where I saw him. Remember?
Now, Luke, you dropped Kelly Troy off on the mountain just up from Breakheart Hill on the afternoon of May 27th. Isn't that right?
That is correct, sir.
About what time would you say it was?
About 3:30.
And after you dropped Kelly off, did you come down the mountain by yourself?
Yes, sir.
All the way back down the mountain to Choctaw. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
And on the way back down the mountain, did you have occasion to see anybody else up on that ridge?
I did.
And where did you see that person?
Right out in front of Grierson's store.
What was he doing?
Walking up to the mountain.
Towards where exactly?
Breakheart Hill.
How far would you say Grierson's is from Breakheart Hill, Luke?
About a mile or so.
It would take about 30 minutes to walk that. Isn't that right?
Give or take a few.
Now look, if you saw him again, would you recognize the person walking up that hill?
I would.
Is that person in the courtroom today?
They are.
Could you please point him out and say his name?
Lyle Gates.
Now when you saw Lyle Gates, he was on foot, isn't that right?
Correct.
Was there a car or a truck anywhere around?
Not that I saw.
You only saw Lyle Gates, is that correct?
I did.
And now, son, I have to ask you
one more time, because so much rides on your answer. Are you sure that you saw Lyle Walter Gates walking up toward Breakheart Hill at approximately 3:30 on the afternoon of May 27th?
Yes, sir.
You saw him with your own eyes.
These ones right here.
I'm having a Christmas party at the Turtle Grove Country Club in a few weeks. You and Kelly should come.
Why Kelly and I?
Because you two are friends, and I don't want any stags there.
What if she wants to ask someone else?
I doubt it. Kelly intimidates boys.
I guess I could talk to her.
Okay, cool. Don't touch me, Yuji!
Kelly! Sheila's planning a Christmas party in a couple of weeks. It's sort of a semi-formal dance at the Turtle Grove Country Club. It's just for couples, so everyone has a dance partner. She thought that you and I might like to go.
Okay.
I mean, the two of us, together.
I know what you meant, Ben.
I thought you'd forgotten me.
Never.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Sheila's got me playing butler tonight.
They'd want to see the world a little.
Maybe they're not interested in the rest of the world.
You just think they're great, Kelly, because you're from a big city.
I don't think they're great.
Nice, basically quaint.
Why do you hate them so much, Ben? What did they ever do to you?
Nothing to me personally. It's what they do to themselves, what they settle for.
Look at Luke just dancing away. You haven't asked me yet. Don't you ever dance?
Me? Dance, Kelly? I'm too serious for that.
No, you're not.
Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got.
I ain't got time for you, baby. Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby. Right here, right now is all we got. A little party. Kill nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop. A little party never kill nobody. Right here, right now is all we get. Skeetin' bada pop.
You know, for the first time, I don't feel like the new girl anymore.
I'm glad.
At first, I was afraid I wouldn't like it here. Moving from a big city, you know, to a small town.
Well, I guess Choctaw has its charms.
It taught me something. It taught me basically every place has the whole world in it. Everything that happens, happens everywhere. But maybe in a small town, you can see it better. See you in school. Something for the next issue. If you like it.
Mind if I take a seat?
Sure, go ahead.
Hi, Kelly.
There's a new girl in school. Mr. Avery asked me to show her around this morning. I don't think I should have showed her around, though. I think you should have showed her around instead, Kelly.
Why?
Because you probably know what it's like kind of being new and all.
What's the new girl's name?
Noreen Donovan. She's from Gadsden. She's a sophomore, and she seemed nice.
Why did she move to Choctaw?
Because of what's going on in Gadsden. Her daddy didn't want her living there anymore. Those demonstrations with the colored people and all.
I didn't know that there was that much going on in Gadsden. It's not in the papers.
They keep it out, Noreen says, but it's pretty much a constant thing.
What is? What exactly are they doing?
They set up picket lines mostly, at the shopping center on your way into Gadsden. Noreen's family used to live really close to there, and her daddy didn't want to be, you know, involved with it all, so that's why they moved up here. They were scared of what could happen if they stayed close to it.
But you said there hasn't been any trouble.
Not yet, but you never know what might happen in a situation like that. It could happen here. The colored folk haven't been treated right. If I would have been treated like them, I would have been demonstrating a long time ago.
Going to a show this weekend?
Todd is gonna ask you out. I could tell by the way he was talking to you.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he is. He's probably gonna ask you to the show.
Even if he did, I wouldn't go.
Why is that?
Because right now, he seems perfect. But it wouldn't be long before he disappointed me.
You really wouldn't go out with him?
Why do you keep asking that?
Because it's hard to believe. All of the girls want to go out with Todd.
I just think it's better to start off with someone who's not so great. Someone who will get better as it goes along.
You really feel that way?
You know, I don't think Todd ever got over Kelly Troy.
I guess not.
Did you?
It wasn't the same with Kelly and me.
You mean she never loved you? At least, not in the same way that she loved Todd.
Todd's son looked sour at the funeral. Raymond always looks sour.
He'll come to a bad end, I think.
He already has. Todd wasn't a good father.
Why did he treat Raymond that way? And Mary, too? Was it the drinking that made him do things like this? Todd being the way he was, I guess not much was expected from Raymond. I guess he wanted a different son. You can never tell why a relationship goes bad.
I think maybe we should talk to the girl from Gadsden.
What about?
About what's going on in Gadsden. She probably knows a lot about it.
Why would you want to talk to her about that?
For a story!
Gadsden's over 30 miles from here. It's way out of range for the Wildcat.
But what's happening there is happening all over the South. Could happen in Choctaw, too.
I don't think so.
Why not?
Because it's all being stirred up by outsiders. Besides, the colored folks here in Choctaw have it nice.
You think they're satisfied with the way things are in Choctaw? You think it's different for them here?
Well, not exactly satisfied.
Well, what then? You're either satisfied or not.
I mean, they have it better in Choctaw than they do in many other places around here. Better than in Black Belt and Mississippi, for instance.
You really think that, Ben? Have you seen the colored cemetery?
Yeah? What about it?
That's not right, something like that. The Negroes were buried without so much as a headstone. They won't stand for that forever, even in Choctaw. I think we should talk to Noreen about it.
Yeah, I guess we should.
Hello, I'm Noreen Donovan.
Hi, I'm Kelly Troy.
Hello.
Hi, my name's Ben. I'm glad Miss Carver gave you the message. Kelly and I work on the Wildcat.
What's that?
The school paper.
We understand you moved here from Gadsden. That's what we wanted to talk to you about.
You want to talk to me about Gadsden? There's nothing to say.
It's more about what's going on there. Just the demonstrations.
Oh, I don't know anything about that.
But the demonstrations are happening where you lived, right?
Yeah, but once they started, I didn't go anywhere near the shopping center.
Why not?
Because my daddy said not to because there might be trouble. But as far as I saw, the colored people only marched back and forth. Sometimes white people would just stop by and hang out and just look at them.
When did they march?
Pretty much all the time, I guess. Well, until the shopping center closes.
When is that?
At 9, I think. Y'all gonna write about it?
We're thinking about it.
Why?
Because we think we should.
Well, if you want me to, I could go down there with you. We could take my mom's car. But don't expect much.
Get your motor running. What now? Looks like there's not much to write about.
Yes, there is.
They're just going around in a circle. We might as well go back. Heavy metal
thunder, racing with the wind. Go back?
There's nothing to do, Kelly. It's just a bunch of people marching back and forth.
I'm getting out. Are you getting out too?
I guess I have to. What are you gonna do?
I don't know. Talk to them, maybe?
You can't do that.
Why not?
Because it's not something you should get involved in.
Then what is, Ben?
Kelly, wait!
Someone has to be in charge. That's who I'll talk to first. Are you coming with me?
Oh, crap.
Who is it?
Lyle Gates. He's probably down here to start some trouble.
What do you think they're going to do?
I don't know. Just don't say anything about what we're doing.
Ben?
You from Choctaw?
Oh, I know Lyle! She's the new girl I was talking about. The one from up north.
Well, in that case, I take back what I said.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Lyle.
Lyle Gates.
Kelly Troy.
Are you really from up north, like everyone says?
Yes, I am.
Whereabouts?
Baltimore.
Baltimore, huh? Look at that. See what that grip says? Baltimore Oreos. I bought it for my kid the other day, but cracked it on the first hit. I'm gonna get another one. You ever been to an Oreo game? Well, girls don't much like baseball. I suppose you being from up north, you're more used to the cold than we are.
Maybe a little.
I guess you think we have some pretty strange ways down here. Well, I've gotta exchange this bat and get some other stuff for my little girl.
I think we better forget about the marchers for now. Sometime when Lyle's not around.
Well, he just had the bat because he was...
I know. But somebody like him, you gotta watch out for. Let's go back.
Okay.
We didn't do anything.
What did you want to do?
I don't know. For sure, maybe learn something.
And to your knowledge, that was the first time Miss Troy met Lyle Gates. Is that right, Ben?
Yes, it was.
And when was the second time?
Come in! Ah, Ben, good to see you!
Dr. McCoy?
Have a seat. So your father tells me you want to be a doctor. You know, a lot of people want to be a doctor. Nowadays, you see them on the television and all.
I don't watch much television.
Too busy studying? Well, you're gonna have to do a lot of studying if you want to be a doctor.
Yes, sir?
And when you get your degree, what do you expect to do with it, you know? Where are you gonna set up your practice?
Right here in Choctaw.
So you're going to be my competition?
I guess so.
I'm getting old, Dr. Wade. And so, because my son has never been interested in medicine, I have to start thinking about passing my practice on. I would like to pass my practice. On to you, Wade, Dr. Wade.
My guess is it's finally set in.
What's set in?
Homesickness. She's probably been fighting it for a while.
But she seemed to like Choctaw before this. Remember how she was at Sheila Cameron's party?
She can like it okay, but she can also think about what she all left behind up north.
Maybe it just has to do with her father. Maybe he's turned up or written to her or something.
Who's he?
I don't know.
Well, maybe he's dead.
Maybe.
My guess is she's homesick, like I said before. Don't worry, Ben. She'll snap out of it. Maybe you should just ask her.
Sheila tried that, but Kelly didn't really say much.
Well, she's gotta be talking to somebody.
Goodbye, Kelly. Goodbye, Noreen!
Waiting for your mother?
Yep, like always. She's never on time. Never.
I can give you a ride home.
I'd better wait.
Why? She never waits for you.
Good point. Let's go. It'll show her.
Kelly's been acting strange lately. What do you think's the matter with her? She hardly talks to me anymore.
That's why you offered me a ride, isn't it? You just wanted me to tell you things about Kelly. You should have just come right out and told me that's what you were after. If you want to talk about Kelly, Ben, we'll talk about Kelly. I'm not stupid. I know you're in love with Kelly. What do you want to know about Kelly?
It's just she's been acting strange lately. I was wondering if you knew anything about it.
No, I don't. We're not like that. We're not close.
But I see you talking to her sometimes.
It's not really talking. Not like you mean. Not serious. It's just chit-chat.
Okay, I just thought I'd ask.
Ben, I didn't mean to get mad at you before. I know what you're going through. I know it's hard to deal with.
Yeah, it is. Just don't know what to do.
When you love someone, it doesn't mean that they'll love you back. I'll try and talk to Kelly if you want me to.
No, you better not. If she doesn't want to say anything, then she shouldn't have to.
You're a nice boy, Ben.
I like you.
Thanks, Noreen, for everything.
Kelly Troy came to talk to you about this matter. Isn't that right?
Yes, she did.
And that was in the nature of confidence. Am I correct?
I guess so. She said she didn't want me to mention it to anyone.
Okay now, could you tell the court just how the conversation happened that day?
Well, Kelly just came up to me after school one day. She said, Eddie, let me talk to you a minute.
What did Miss Troy tell you, Eddie?
She talked about the night that we met at the shopping center in Gadsden.
That would have been the same night that Ben Way had described to the jury. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
And what did Miss Troy have to say about that night?
She said that it had scared her.
Scared her in what way?
Well, at first I figured that she meant the way the colored people were demonstrating down there. I figured that it had scared her a little, something like that.
But that wasn't what scared Miss Troy, was it?
No, sir.
What had scared her, Mr. Smathers?
Lyle had. At least that's what Kelly said.
What did she say exactly?
She said she'd come down to check out the colored people, what they were doing, but that's when Lyle showed up, and she'd gotten scared to talk to them.
Did she say anything else?
Yes, she did. She said that she'd left disappointed in herself that she'd been scared off by Lyle, and that she'd never walk away from anything like that again.
But why do you think she was telling you this?
Well, I thought maybe she was sending a message to Lyle.
Did you give Lyle the message?
No, sir. I'm not that close with Lyle.
Now, Mr. Smathers, can you tell us how long it was since the meeting with Kelly Troy in Gadsden?
About 3 weeks or so, I guess.
And did Miss Troy say that she had heard from Lylegate since then?
No, she didn't.
Or seen him?
No.
Mr. Smathers, did you see anything frightening in the way that Lylegate had talked to Kelly Troy that evening in Gadsden?
No, ma'am.
In fact, he was pretty friendly to her now, wasn't he?
I guess so.
Did Lyle ever indicate to you that he didn't like Kelly Troy?
No.
Did he ever threaten her in your presence?
No.
Then why, Mr. Smathers, is Lyle Gates accused of doing these horrible things?
I don't know.
Our fathers, the Puritans, they believed that order was the most important thing. You know why order was so important to them, Ben? Our fathers believed that when people did bad or disorderly things, it didn't end with them. It didn't even end with the people they might have hurt. It just keeps going on through time.
So when does it end?
Never. It never ends. So a single act is like a stream. It spurts off the McGowan and runs on forever.
What'd you think about it?
It was beautiful. What did you think about it?
Do you really care what I think?
I haven't been very nice to you lately, Ben. I know. I haven't been nice to a lot of people. I guess they noticed.
Yeah, they have. Miss Carver thought you might be having some kind of trouble.
I was.
You were?
The night in Gadsden threw me off a little bit.
In what way?
It scared me, Ben. That boy. The one with Eddie.
Lyle Gates? He's not really a boy.
He looked like a boy. But what you said about him, it scared me. I've heard other things, too.
That he beat up a kid during a game and he got thrown out of school. That he tried to kidnap his daughter. That he had a gun when he tried to do it. Is all that true, Ben?
I guess so, but it doesn't matter. He doesn't know you or what you were doing that night.
I know that, but he still made me afraid to do what I intended to do that night.
So that's what's been bothering you, Lyle Gates.
Not him, but the way he made me feel.
How?
Like a coward, but I don't want to be a coward. I don't want to go through life like that, disappointing myself and everybody else, being afraid. Would you mind reading it now?
I thought you didn't like when I read your stuff in front of you.
This time I do. Will you publish it, Ben?
You know, writing about the Negroes would cause you problems, don't you?
Yes.
Are you sure you're ready for that? Because it may not come from people like Lyle Gates. It may come from people that you know, your friends.
Why didn't you ever write about anything about that night in Gadsden, Ben?
I guess I was waiting for you to write about it with me.
Were you afraid?
Maybe, but not now. We will never be afraid again.
Try to remember that.
I would never let anyone hurt you, Kelly.
I haven't been very nice to you, Ben. And so I wanted to give you something to make up for it. And maybe just say I'm sorry.
Should I open it now?
If you want.
A stethoscope.
I wanted to get you something really special. Something really nice. It's a real one. But I guess you can tell.
Yes, I can, Kelly. It's wonderful.
You have to see what Kelly Troy saw that afternoon. You have to see something come toward you from out of the bushes. You have to see a man bigger and stronger than you. You have to feel the terrible hatred he has for you and the damage he has come to do you. You have to see all of that in his eyes. And ladies and gentlemen of the jury, although it is autumn now and cold and rain are falling over Breakheart Hill, you have to imagine how beautiful it was on that bright, warm summer day 5 months ago. You have to say to yourself, as Kelly Troy must have said to herself, I will never see such beauty again, or hear the birds and feel the warmth of the sun. You, the members of the jury who have been chosen to render justice in this case, you, each and every one of you, have to do all that before you can understand what happened to that young girl on that bright, sunny day. You have to see what she saw and feel what she felt and understand what she lost and will never see or feel or have again.
It's the ones you love you have to look out for.
What are you talking about?
A man in the paper killed his son so they could go to heaven. What is it, Noreen?
Nothing.
You can publish the article. We can't just turn away from our problems down here.
Guess that's what you call a gentleman down here.
Absolutely.
People who don't like it will say I'm just another outside agitator.
Just another Yankee trying to tell us what to do with our Negroes.
That's right.
Well, some people would probably say that. But if they didn't, they'd probably say something else. But we've got a lot of good people in Choctaw. Basically, it's a nice town.
I thought you hated Choctaw.
Not as much as I used to.
Why not?
Maybe I'm just a little more mature than I was a few months ago.
But do you still want to leave here? As soon as you graduate?
Yes, but maybe just while I'm in college.
And then come back?
Yeah. I saw you here once.
Here? When?
It was just before school started. You were reading.
You and Luke were going to Cuffy's, right?
Right.
It feels strange. There was a time when I didn't know you.
Yes, it does. Especially since we're so close. What do you want to write about for the next issue?
History. I want to find out about Choctaw at various times. Did you know they once had a slave market? It's true. It was the only one in this part of the state.
A slave market? Here in Choctaw?
The bigger ones were in the south, by the cotton plantations. But the only one in the north was in Choctaw.
But there wasn't even much slavery up north. It's too mountainous for plantations.
That's why the market wasn't open all year. It opened in the summer until fall.
How do you know that?
I read about it. The library has a whole section on this area. I could show you sometime.
All right.
Breakheart Hill.
April 7th, 1886. By then, people were already calling it Breakheart Hill.
Maybe it was always called that.
But why? I mean, it's such a strange name.
It probably comes from an old legend. Lots of places have them around here.
What are they about?
Love. Sort of Indian versions of Romeo and Juliet. Doomed love, as Miss Carver would call it.
Do you think the legend of Breakheart Hill is about doomed love?
Probably.
What right do you think you had to write that essay? What right did you think you had? We've had this balance for years and years and years. And you think that they can just be equals to us. What don't you understand?
The white people are just using the Negroes to do the jobs they don't want to.
You make it sound like they're still slaves, Kelly.
Well, aren't they? When you can't vote or send your child to a decent school, aren't you a slave? What if you were an adult and you had to call everybody Miss or Mrs., even if they were a child? Have you ever seen a Negro policeman in Choctaw? They can't even deliver the mail here. They have to take the lowest jobs, jobs the white people don't want. If that's slavery, and you all know it.
Tough day.
I just want to be done.
Seriously, love smelling my own urine.
Hi, Kelly. I just wanted to tell you that I thought your article was great.
Me too, Kelly. It was great that you wrote it. We're all so proud of you, aren't we, Todd?
Very proud.
Has anybody said anything to you? I mean, anything bad?
I think a few people didn't like it, but nobody said anything really bad to me.
Well, most people in Choctaw are nice. Todd agrees with you. He thinks the colored people have been mistreated here in the South.
So do I.
He thinks something should be done about it.
Yes, it does.
Well, if anybody gives you any trouble, Todd will protect you. Isn't that right, Todd?
Yes, I will. I really will, Kelly.
Thank you, Todd. That was nice of him.
Yeah, it was.
I found some evidence.
Evidence of what?
That something strange happened on Breakheart Hill. Something the Negroes couldn't forget.
What do you mean, couldn't forget?
They used to have a kind of commemoration on April 17th. The local papers called it a Negro festivity. It had something to do with the old slave market. The slave market was located at the bottom of Breakheart Hill, and April 17th was the date it closed.
Maybe they were celebrating the fact that it closed.
No, it wasn't a celebration. It was a race.
A race?
Well, more of a commemoration of the races once held at Breakheart Hill. I found a memoir about it. Doesn't sound like a celebration at all.
I found a memoir.
I found a letter, too. The girl who wrote it, her father wouldn't tell her what happened on Breakheart Hill. What could have happened to make a father not want to tell his daughter?
Maybe there was a lynching or something. Or a murder. Or rape.
Now you and Kelly arrived at Cuffy's at around 6 o'clock in the evening, is that right?
Yes, sir.
And you just went in and sat down?
Yeah, we did.
I've already called Taylor Pruitt. He was very nice. He said he can talk to me tomorrow. Mrs. Phillips thinks he knows the whole story.
That would be great.
How y'all doing?
Pretty good. What about you, Lyle?
I remember you from Gadsden.
Hi.
Kelly Troy, right? From Baltimore. That explains you writing that piece about the Negroes.
So Lyle Gates knew that Kelly Troy was the one that had written about the Negroes and told her so. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
And how did Miss Troy react?
I think she was shocked.
What did she do?
She just stared at him for a second. Then she got up.
What the hell? Run, you Negro-loving wench!
What did you just call her?
I called her a Negro-loving wench!
Take it back.
You Choctaw High people think you're so great!
Take it back.
They threw me out of that school and now they're trying to put Negroes into it!
Take back what you said about Kelly.
Come on, Ben, let's go! Come on, please, Ben! Are you alright, Ben? I'm sorry I got you into this.
I'm okay.
Hello?
Hi, Ben.
Oh, hey, Kelly.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
Really?
Yeah, how are you?
I'm fine, but I wasn't the one who got hit.
My father gave me some ice to put on my eye after you left. But it's still kind of swollen. Other than that, I'm okay.
I'm sorry, Ben. I didn't mean to.
No, it's nothing. By Monday, no one will even notice.
Well, anyway, I wanted to let you know that I went up to see Mr. Pruitt this morning.
Who?
The man I told you about on the way to Cuffy's yesterday. The one who was supposed to know a lot about Choctaw. Well, Mrs. Phillips was right. He did know a lot.
That's great.
As a matter of fact, I found out why they call it Breakheart Hill.
You did?
And so I thought we might drive up there this afternoon. It would be easier to explain if we were actually there and I could show you a few things.
Okay, when do you want me to pick you up?
Well, I thought you might want to have lunch with my mother and me, and after that we could go up to the hill.
Alright.
So, could you come here at around noon?
Well, I'll see you then.
Noon. Okay, then.
Did they offer the winners freedom?
No,
They wanted to sell them, remember? The white people lined up in two lines on the hill. They herded the Negro men to the bottom. They wore ankle chains, but their hands were free, so they could claw at each other or the ground. They couldn't walk. There was a band to keep the people entertained. A band! It always started at noon and began after the market owner fired his dual pistol. On the sidelines, the people cheered them on. Some even placed bets. Someone made it through the ribbon. They were the winner.
What was the prize?
Freedom.
But I thought you said they were trying to sell the slaves.
Not freedom for himself, but for his youngest child.
Are you sure about all this, Kelly?
The market owner had an agreement with the abolitionists up north. They took the child. The owner was only allowed to have it a couple of times, because it was against the law. They called it a despicable and unnatural display.
That it was.
There was even talk of having the slave market owner arrested. But since he had the child transported out of Alabama before he freed him, he hadn't broken the law. And so they called it Breakheart Hill. And after the war, the Negroes started having their commemoration.
Only this time, the winner was given a bundle of cloth that was supposed to represent his child.
Giving it back to him.
Kelly, we need to tell this whole story in the Wildcat. Let everyone know what happened here. Do you want me to take some pictures? Do you mind?
No. No, I don't. I guess it just pushed me over the edge.
Forget about what happened for a while. Do you have to go home now? Or do you want to maybe go to my house and sit on the porch for a bit?
No, I don't have to go home yet.
Alright, let's go.
Out here. Do you sit out here a lot?
In the summer I do.
With your father?
Mostly by myself. That's pretty.
It was my grandfather's.
A family heirloom?
When my grandmother gave it to me, she said I should keep it until I'd given myself to someone. I guess she meant my husband. So I guess that's what I'll do.
Why didn't she give it to your mother?
I guess she thought my mother wouldn't need it. Of course, I'm not sure I'll ever need it either.
Sure you will, Kelly.
Maybe so.
When you're cold, your lips turn purple.
I thought love was only true and fair.
Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not, be not sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Thy lips are warm. Yea, noise, then I'll be brief. O happy dagger, this is thy sheath. There, rust, and let me die.
Oh, bid me into a new-made grave, and hide me with a dead man in a shroud. The things that, to hear them told, have made me tremble, and I will do it without fear or doubt, to live an unstained wife to my sweet love.
Wow, Kelly, that was great.
I think everybody did.
Well, I don't know. Mary kind of made Juliet look like she was from Gone with the Wind.
Well, maybe a Southern Juliet would be interesting.
No, it's you, Kelly. You should be Juliet.
Well, if I play Juliet, why don't you play Romeo?
No, I'm not an actor.
But you're perfect for it, Tad. You're the only boy at Choctaw High who is.
Hey, y'all. We're all going to Cuffy's. You want to come?
No, I have to go home.
What about you?
You can't go for just a few minutes?
No, I have to go help my father with something.
Would you be able to give me a ride after we went to Cuffy's?
Sure.
I'll just get a ride with Todd today.
Okay.
You should go out for the play, Ben. Paris! Miss Carver's still looking for a Paris.
I don't think so. Well, I guess that's it for the Wildcat. Thanks for all the hard work you did this year, Kelly.
I guess we'll make it even better next year. Ben, did I do something? Are you mad at me?
No, why would I be mad?
Well, with the way you've been acting lately, it made me wonder if I'd done something. If I have, I'm sorry.
No, you haven't done anything. There's just been stuff going on at home.
Okay, then. Well, I better go. The cast is meeting up with Miss Carver to make a rehearsal schedule.
Okay. Bye.
Bye, Ben.
It's like a cave in here.
She worked right here.
Where did you work?
Right here.
Who took this?
I did.
When?
A few weeks ago.
Same dress? Same place? Had you taken her there often?
She took me there, but only that one time.
Mighty pretty girl.
Yes.
Strange place for her, way up yonder on Breakheart Hill. Got any idea why she might have been up there all by herself?
No, sir.
Shame what happened to her. Do you have any idea who might have done this to her?
No, sir.
Do you think it might have been Lyle Gates?
Lyle Gates?
That's right. We knew he was in the vicinity of Breakheart Hill when that terrible thing happened to Kelly. Of course, that wouldn't mean much in itself, except I understand he had some pretty harsh words for her over at Cuffy's a while back. And you and Gates had a little tussle over it, I hear.
Yeah, we did.
Did you have any trouble since?
No.
Did she?
Not that I know of.
You got a car, Ben?
Yes, sir.
Ever been down that old mining road at the bottom of Breakheart Hill? Well, I found some car tracks down there, Ben. The thing is, Lyle Gates was on foot. His car had been repossessed a couple weeks before. So if Lyle was on foot, it couldn't have been his car tracks that were down there. So what I'm wondering is, can you think of anybody else that would have wanted to hurt Kelly?
No, sir.
Besides Gates, I mean.
No, sir, I can't think of anybody else.
Well, don't say no too fast, son. Dwell on it a minute. Is there anybody around town who might have had some bad feelings for Kelly?
I can't think of anybody.
How about around school? Any of the boys been bothering her?
I don't think so.
How about her boyfriend, what's his name?
Todd Jeffries.
That's right. She been having any trouble with him?
No, sir. They weren't having any trouble.
So, as far as you know, nobody else was having a problem with her. Nobody but Lyle Gates. Just Lyle Gates? He's the only one that might have been having some trouble with Kelly?
Yeah, just Lyle Gates.
What about a girl?
A girl?
A girl might have had some reason to hurt Kelly. Girls get bad feelings for each other like that, don't they?
Yes.
And since there wasn't any rape or anything like that, we have to take that into a possibility. Tell you the truth, Ben, we don't know what happened up there on Breakheart Hill. The details, you know. One thing's for sure, we found a rock with blood on it. Of course, it was pretty far away from where we found Kelly herself. Anyways, it was too big to pick up and hit her with. We think she fell on it, then tried to run back up the hill. She was blind by then, you know.
Blind?
That's what Dr. McCoy thinks. In the last stage, you know. Still able to run. Losing strength, but still able to run. Crawling by the end of it. At least by the looks of her dress. One thing's for sure, she got hit in the face real hard. So, Ben, you can't think of anybody that might have wanted to hurt Kelly?
No, sir, I can't think of anyone.
You don't?
No.
Well, you were at the play rehearsals, weren't you?
Yes.
You didn't notice anything, did you?
No.
What about Mary Deal? I heard there was some bad blood between the Deal girl and Kelly. Do you know anything about that? What was all that about? The trouble between Kelly and Mary Deal?
Love.
I need to talk to you, Kelly.
We'll have to go with Miss Carver right now. She's taking me home.
No, no, you have to talk to me now. You have to, right now.
Maybe tomorrow, Mary. We could talk tomorrow.
No, I can't wait till tomorrow. I have to talk to you now.
Mary, maybe you should let Kelly get on home. I have to drive her back home and it's awfully late.
No, I want to talk to Kelly. I don't want to wait. I have to know. What's going on between you and Todd?
What do you want to know?
Well, I mean, I just want to know what it is. What's going on between you and Todd?
Love.
I wish you were dead.
Oh, good morning, Miss Troy.
Oh, and it's so good to see you.
Come in and sit down, Miss Troy.
Oh, thank you.
Now, are you feeling all right?
Oh, yes, I'm fine.
Is there something I can do for you? Anything?
Well, you remember that a few months back, at your father's funeral, I mentioned that I might have a favor to ask.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this morning, I had to go to the courthouse to get a few things in order, and I just thought I'd stop by
And what, Miss Troy?
And ask if you might be able to come by the house tonight.
I just couldn't.
I'm sorry, Ben. I shouldn't have asked you. I know how you felt about Kelly. That's why I understand why you never came back to the house after what happened.
No, I'll come by. Do you need help? Is that it?
I'm too old to manage sometimes. Things get put off, I know.
Of course they do, Miss Troy.
But it's not right, Ben, just to let things go.
I understand.
I know it's not your job to help me, Ben, but I was just thinking, the way it was with you and Kelly, I just thought that you would be the one to...
I'll come by this evening. Just tell me what time I should be there.
Just when your work here is over, Ben, and I really do appreciate it. Thank you.
Thus, with a kiss, I die.
Todd's good.
Yes, he is. I have to go talk to Todd for a second. Could you take over for me? Here,
Hold this.
So what are you doing out here?
Nothing.
Miss Carver said that everybody but Todd and Kelly could go home, but I wanted to smoke first. Want one? You gotta hand it to Todd and Kelly. They're really putting in some effort on this thing. You know, she probably wants to give them some last-minute tips. Romeo! Romeo! What bull cranberry! Oh, the girls fall for Todd, but I think he never really fell for anybody, but man, he really has a thing for Kelly.
He wouldn't if he knew.
What?
Nothing.
If who knew what?
If Todd knew about Kelly's daddy.
Kelly's daddy? What about him?
Maybe it's not true.
Maybe what's not true?
You know, what people say.
What are you talking about, Ben?
You know, Kelly's father is a Negro.
What are you saying, Ben? Did Kelly tell you that? She told you that, Ben? She told you that her father was a Negro?
Don't tell Todd, though. I mean it, Eddie. Don't tell Todd.
I don't know, Noreen. I don't know when I'll be home tonight. I know it's been really long. It's been over 30 years. I know I don't know what to expect, Noreen. But Miss Troy's just too old to do things by herself now. She can't manage on her own. Her family's gone. She's frail. She can barely walk even with her cane. She needs help. And I'm the only one who can. I don't think so. Miss Troy knows that she's near the end. That's why she asked me to help her. Because she knows this will be the last time.
Ah, Ben, it's so nice of you to come. The place is, well, as you can see. I sure do appreciate you coming by. I know it must make a mighty long day for you.
Don't worry about it, ma'am.
I'm sorry you never came by to visit sooner, but I do understand how you must have felt. The way it was between you and Kelly, I knew it just would have been too hard for you to come here.
Yes, ma'am.
That's why I really do appreciate you coming here tonight. I know this can't be easy for you. I guess you heard about Gates. About them shooting him sometime back.
Yeah, I heard about that.
I guess I should have been able to forgive him. But I just couldn't. Not after what he did. I just kept seeing what that girl saw that one day. What was her name?
Edith Sparks.
Kelly's blood on his hands. Even when I heard he was dead, even then I couldn't forgive him. Could you, Ben?
I guess not, Miss Troy.
It's just in me, that hatred towards him. I guess he might have a hard heart, you might say. Well, Kelly sure would be proud of you, Ben, becoming a doctor and all, just like you said you always would. She'd be surprised to hear that you came back to Choctaw, though. She never expected you to come back. She thought you'd end up in a big city, Atlanta, or somewhere up north. Why did you come back, Ben?
I thought I owed it something.
I suppose that's a nice way to think about it.
It's about the only way I can think about it, I guess.
Well, I sure did pick a bad night to ask you over here, but there's no one else I could have asked.
I understand.
With no family at all, no husband. Did Kelly ever tell you about her father?
No, ma'am.
He wasn't a bad man, you know. And he sure loved Kelly, at least while she let him. But he got involved with another woman. And you know, it happens sometimes.
Yes, ma'am.
But Kelly wouldn't have anything to do with him after what he did. He tried to come and see her many times, but she wouldn't have anything to do with him. Just 5 years old, but she had her own mind. He had disappointed her so. That was one of Kelly's problems. She cut people off, just like she did her father. Just cut him off. But, you know, Ben, there's one thing I'm really glad that Kelly got to experience.
What's that, Miss Troy?
That before Lyle Gates got his hands on her, she got to experience a little taste of love. I know she loved you, Ben. She's told me.
We were friends.
There's something I want you to have, Ben. I'm sure Kelly would have wanted it for you. Her grandmother's ring. Sheriff Stone found it at the bottom of Breakheart Hill, and I just really want you to have it.
Found it where?
Right at the bottom of Breakheart Hill, towards that old mining road. It got pulled right off her finger. Never could understand how it got pulled right off her finger. I guess that'll always remain a mystery, Ben.
Yes.
Well, there's no use thinking about it. People just have to accept things. Well, we should probably get to work now. Well, there's not much left to do. Down this way. Right in here. Thank you, Ben, for doing this.
Kelly.
No, don't be afraid.
Kelly.
I know this must be hard for you, but she needs a bath, and I'm just too old to do this by myself.
I'll help you.
Thank you. I'll go draw a bath.
That was the answer all along. Todd must have heard from Eddie what I said about Kelly's father. Lyle Gates was sent to prison and killed for an act he did not commit. Todd Jeffries was the one to blame all along. He took Kelly away from me and from everyone else that loved her. But there is still one thing that I must do.
You're up late. What's the matter, Ben? What is it? What is this about?
Love.
We'll be right back.